Last year I taught everybody how to use relays and I kind of regret it because there's a much easier way. Now it's a little more pricey, but I think if you stick with me through this video, you're gonna see why. And this is a review of the Garmin Power Switch. Now we installed the Garmin Power Switch to control all of the lights on the front of our camper van, and it has a ton of features, and it's Bluetooth, so you don't have to run any wires into the camper, and you control it with your phone or with the touchscreen in the transit dash. So let's go over what this is and what we can do with it. So yesterday I made a training board with the Garmin Power Switch to show you a few different things that this can do, but we're just gonna start with the absolute most basic features of this and then work our way over to the more complicated setups that we can do, as well as a feature that this should have in it, but it unfortunately doesn't, and I found a hack to make it work. So first and foremost, inside of the Garmin Power Switch box is the Garmin Power Switch itself, as well as a positive wire that is going to go to the positive terminal of your starting battery or other appropriate power terminal in your vehicle. On our transit van, I have this going to the jump starting terminal. The negative, or the ground coming out of the Garmin, that's going to go to the negative terminal of the starting battery or other appropriate chassis ground, like I've got demoed here. And the Garmin Switch has 6 buttons right here on the front that can turn off and on the various loads that we have connected to them. And the Bluetooth capability that I showed earlier means that on your phone, you can do the same thing that you would be doing on the actual power switch. And with the phone, if you connect that to a vehicle that is compatible with the Garmin Power Switch, like our Transit is, this is going to show up right on the touchscreen, which makes it really, really nice user interface. So let's start looking at the various wiring options and what we can do and the customizability that we can achieve with this Garmin Power Switch. Just undo the cover here and get it out of the way for now. Over here, I have 2 lights. They are just wired to the positives, to terminal 5 and terminal 6, and their negatives are going to a chassis ground point. And we can just control those independently from the app, terminal 5, terminal 6. And then on the app, we can actually go up here to edit, and then we can change what these are called. And if we wanted to, we could even change these to be a momentary push, like so, or we could set them to strobe if you wanted to for some reason that I have no idea why you would even want to do that. But we're gonna leave them on normal. And it's also got some other functions down here that we'll get to in a bit. And we'll do the same thing for number 6. And we have our top and bottom light to where we can turn those on and off. So an example of what we could use this for is our ditch lights that are mounted up on top of the hood of our van. At really no point in time do I ever want my ditch lights to not be, you know, to be able to be controlled independently. So we have options to turn both of these on at the same time by doing this. We can click our plus here, tap the plus button to add a new custom button. And then add action, select our device. This is the device I have right here. Go down to top light, turn on, add action, bottom light, turn on, and then back out of there. And now under our custom screen right here, we turn both of our ditch lights on. Now, if we wanted to turn these off, you can't really do that here, unfortunately, as of right now, but we can create another custom button that's going to be all off. Add action. Top light, turn off. Add action. Bottom light, turn off. And we can turn those off. And I think you can get the picture of how you can kind of customize this screen to turn things on and off. And what we're showing here would also show up on the touchscreen on the dash of our Transit, but for the sake of the tabletop demonstration, we're not going to show that on the touchscreen, and all programming is going to happen through your phone or tablet. Now, you can absolutely put more than one light on each circuit just by wiring your lights in parallel. The consideration here is that each of these terminals on this switch can put out 30 amps, and this entire unit can put out 100 amps total. And you don't have to fuse any of these as long as you're using proper wire sizes, because this will never be able to put out over 30 amps. If we asked for more than 30 amps or a short circuit happened, this circuit would simply shut off. So those are the two basic functions of the Garmin power switch. Now let's talk about our control terminals right down here, which is what we skipped over earlier, right down here with automation, saying that control one activates this button and control input two activates this button. We have control input number one and control input number two. And this simply means that if control number one or control number two sees a voltage, either one, it's going to send that information to any of these that we program. So let's go for the example of saying that we wanted to turn on our ditch lights right here whenever our ignition is on. And I have a switch right here. It's just a simple switch that is turning off and on this light. And we're going to use our imagination and pretend that this is the key to our vehicle and this light is our engine. And I have power coming into the switch, power is going out to start our engine, and then I've tapped off wire from the power side or from the downstream side of the switch to go to control input number two. So now what I'm going to do is, since we're in the programming for the top light over here, and this switch is connected to control input number two, I'm going to say that control input number two activates this button. Now I can back out. And now I can see that whenever we turn on our engine, if you will, and control two gets power, the top light number one turns on, turns off, turns on. This is really good for like daytime running lights or something like that. Now, the thing that the Garmin power switch doesn't do at the moment that I think could be fixed with a simple firmware update. So if any of y'all have contacts at Garmin, point them toward this video because this would be an awesome feature. But we can't turn this light on and off from the switch whenever we have it controlled by our control input. I wish that there was an automation feature here that was control input two allows for toggle. That could be a simple wording here that would allow us to have this on, but still be able to turn this on and off. And the reason that I would love to have that feature is, let's pretend that this is our headlights for just a second, and this is simply our high beam selector on the side of our steering wheel. It sure would be nice as if we had our high beams on, and let's say that we have this big light that's illegal, you know, shining down the road, and I forget to turn off my high beams in time. But Steph is riding in the passenger seat, and she's able to just reach up to the touchscreen dash and turn off that. So she has some power to control lights as well. That would be a super great feature to be able to do that. The other and maybe more useful reason would be if we're just going down the highway or the interstate using our regular high beams, there's really no way to like disable this and still allow our high beams to function, which basically means that anytime our high beams are on, all of our off-road lighting is going to be on, which usually isn't preferable. So, like I said, that is a thing that would be fixed with a control input 2 toggles this button. But I've also figured out kind of a hack to make it work. So what I have set up here with this relay as the hack to make this feature work is I have another switch that is considered our high beams. Let's just pretend these are our factory vehicle high beams that are controlled by the switch that are that's on the side of the steering wheel. This purple wire here is taking voltage from the downstream side of our high beam switch, and it is going into this relay to turn the coil on and off. That's going over to our chassis ground here. So anytime this headlight is on, this relay is active and is able to flow power. Now, where is it flowing power from? So if I turn on number 3 here, that's sending power out through this orange wire, through this closed relay, and then out to control input number 1. And so if we go into our programming here and go to number 1, change it to light bar, and then say that control input number 1 activates this button, then that means that the light bar is being turned on and off whenever we apply voltage to control number 1 here. And we're unfortunately still met with the exact same problem here that we can't turn this off and on or disable it whenever it's just going to always turn on whenever our headlights turn on. So what we want to do here is actually we want to be able to selectively turn control, you know, toggle control 1 like I've been talking about here by doing this. So just go ahead and rename number 3 here, since that's the one that's sending power through the relay, to switched light bar. And then back out to the main screen, done editing. And what happens is our switch light bar, we can now toggle it on and off because number 3 is controlling C1 like so. And now if we turn our headlights off, then our light bar is going off. If we turn our switch light bar on and off, it's not really doing anything. And we can still turn our light bar on just from this switch like it's designed, but this whole relay scenario that we just described gives us that toggle function that I wish came natively in here. And if Garmin kind of fixes this to include that scenario, then I'll add it to the video description below or to the pinned comment. And that's pretty much it. I'm actually super, super happy with this Garmin power switch, even with that one little gripe I have about the toggle function for the controls. And you know, the way we have it set up in our Transit, it just works super good. I've got our off-road spots, our off-road snow and fogs, and you know, I've got a video of all of our lighting on the exterior of our Transit in a separate video that I'll leave a link to down in the video description, and all kinds of other cool features that we put on the front of that. Now, this is kind of pricey, but ultimately it gets rid of a lot of the difficulties of using a bunch of relays to control all of your lights and everything like that. Now the Bluetooth functionality of this, you know, this is going to be installed up underneath the hood, and then the phone or your touch screen is going to be on the inside. And I have not had this lose Bluetooth connectivity even a single time. And we've had it installed for about 2 months at this point. So ultimately, I'm super happy with how this works. So if you're considering this or the functionalities of outdoor lighting, I did hope that this helped, and we'll see you next time.